What's up everyone, it is Corey from Morph Gaming, and today we're playing some Titanfall. I have actually already got to Gen 10 on this game, as you can see on screen, which is pretty much the leveling or prestige system on Titanfall, and right there you can see my pilot and Titan setup, which just pause right there if you want to copy my setup and see if it works for you, try it out for yourself. Today we're going to be playing some campaign, and if you don't know, campaign in Titanfall is pretty much multiplayer, but with like campaign mission cutscenes going on in the background. So what you're going to see is basically things usually getting destroyed most of the time in the background, and then some sort of like chat coming popping up between the main characters while you're playing the multiplayer game. Right here you're going to see how important rooftops are in this game. And this guy gets really unlucky, getting taken out by a couple arc grenades, leaves his Titan all alone. And how is this for a jump? Tell me this is not the longest you have ever seen. Makes me feel like Batman or something. Look at that. And my dome shield actually ends up taking out his Titan, so keep an eye out for that. The dome shields actually do a lot of damage to enemy units which are in it, so don't try and rodeo the enemy Titan before it comes out of the dome shield. And don't even bother shooting at it if you're in another Titan, because nothing's going to go through that dome shield until it comes out. This guy, trying to get some arc grenade revenge right there. You can see how badly it messes up your screen. You can't see a thing when you get an arc grenade thrown at you. So pretty much what you're going to want to do is run away like a coward and shoot randomly. You probably escape alive. And as you can see right there, you can jump down anywhere over the map. The Titans are actually surprisingly nimble. This guy, I swear, is like a Bugs Bunny or something. Look at him hopping all over the place. So I decided to give him a carrot-shaped cluster missile in the face. There we go. Over here, I actually lost the enemies for about 30 seconds straight. Like, I know they're on the right of the screen there, but if you look at your map, you can sort of see up the top left, you can sort of see the pilots popping up. And I saw that guy pop out there. I can't get any shots, I didn't get any hit markers. I don't know where he went, so I just put down some smoke to prevent the pilots from locking on. If you don't know that, the smoke also damages enemies. It's electric smoke, whatever, it's the future, but it also blocks missiles from coming in and hitting you, so put down some electric smoke if you're getting locked on, and it'll probably prevent it, usually, most of the time. This is some Titan versus Titan battles going on here, and I actually do manage to get the kill on this guy, but seeing as I have auto-eject and nuclear ejection on, which are really good, I do suggest you use them, and I'm inside, that's when I suggest don't use it, but you don't have the option. You've got it on, you're gonna die, and you're gonna kill yourself. So, one suicide on the board, chalk it up right there. I took my hand off of the controller there for some reason, I don't know what's going on there. Pepper this guy with a couple arc grenades, he can't see a thing. Jump on, rodeo him, and start shooting at the internals. That's gonna damage him really quickly. And if you're good at riding mechanical bulls, then in all possibility, you might have a bright future as a pilot. So don't try that at home, but, you know, feel good about yourself. If this ever became a reality, you'd be a good pilot. And basically, you're going to want to shoot at the internals, and the pilot's either going to eject, like that guy did, and then you can take them out, or he's going to die inside the Titan and, you know, go down with the ship like a true captain. Not really. Not at all. But this game, the really good thing about it is how fast-paced it is. Compared to COD and a lot of other games, it's much, much faster. And I actually spent a lot of time on it, as you can tell, 100%ed it, all the achievements, all the levels. And when I went back to COD, it felt so slow in comparison. That's why I really like this. The action just keeps going, and there's pretty much never a dull moment. And as you can see right there, I was sort of like popping in and out of my dome shield, using it as cover. It's actually really good cover because no one can shoot through it at all, and it only stays down for a few seconds, but if the opportunity presents itself, go for it. Why not? And right here you can see, when you have a few friendly Titans gang up on someone, you can completely steamroll through them. And another thing I'm going to show you right here is you can actually hear the pilots rodeoing your Titan before the warning actually comes up on the screen. So just hop out, shoot that nasty little head crab off your Titan, and get back in. This guy's actually trying to shoot down at me at the same time while I got out, which is something you're going to notice a lot. I swear every single time you get out of your Titan, the pilots are going to think, oh, easy pickings, and just start shooting at your Titan. And then the second you get back in, they run away again. This weapon is probably the best weapon in the game, I reckon. It is the quad rocket with the rapid fire upgrade, which lets you just shoot semi-automatic fire has a heap of rounds in it. I think it's like 15 or something. Let's see when it reloads. 18. And for some reason, I turned away there and ran away from the battle. And look at the kill feed. Tried to flee the battle. Thank you. Successfully fleed the battle. Yeah. I did come back though and help out the teammate and get a Muhammad Ali beatdown kill on the Titan. Right here, I got really paranoid for some reason. I saw some guy locking on and then I couldn't see him. I thought he was up there, but clearly he wasn't. I think he got killed in that electric smoke, actually. Running into walls like a complete pro. Getting scared by grunts like a complete pro. And turns out there was actually a Titan right here. Now what you're going to want to do is pretty much just lay down your smoke and your cluster missile right in front of the enemy Titans, and they're going to have to run through, and that's going to do a huge amount of damage to them. Even if they get a drop on you, you're probably going to be able to finish them off after that, even if they take down your Titan. And right here, as you can see, I was rodeoing this guy. So when he got taken out, I got ejected at the same time as him. And look at that. Trying to shoot him midair. I actually missed the shot, but I got him when he came down and secured us the victory. And that is Titanfall, pretty much. After that, you're actually going to have a little epilogue scene, which is pretty much the team which lost has to escape and the team which won has to prevent them from escaping. I usually just like to roam around the map and try get kills, but if you are trying to take out the ship, top tip for that is pretty much get in your Titan, go underneath it and use a nuclear ejection right underneath it, and it's going to take out a huge amount of health off the escape ship. Same deal if you're trying to escape, do the same thing. It's going to defend your ship pretty well, and you can actually eject straight into the evac ship. Not sure if they patched that yet, but I don't think they would have, and that's a really, really nice, fun way to end the game. Even though, you know, people actually tend to forget, like, whether they won or lost because of the little evac scene. They base, like, how well they did on the evac scene, which is kind of fun for the people who haven't played the game as much. It's a nice little thing for the losing team. Even though, it doesn't actually matter that much. That's a secret. And there you have it, 71 attrition points, 10 pilot kills, 6 Titan kills, 10 minions, which are the AI, and 1 suicide. Not a bad game. Let me know if you want to see some more Titanfall. I haven't actually played the DLC yet, so that's an option. Otherwise, Destiny beta soon, and until then, happy gaming.